Now, so far, we have been looking at the compounds which are formed of carbon and hydrogen. Okay, they are called as hydrocarbons. We already seen the definition of hydrocarbons. Okay, the compounds which are composed of carbon and hydrogen only are called as hydrocarbons. But carbon can form bond with other elements too, like oxygen, like halogen, okay, like sulfur. And these atoms which substitutes hydrogen in hydrocarbons are known as heteroatoms, are known as heteroatoms. Okay, now here, what are the functional groups? Now let us see the atoms or group of atoms when present in a compound determines the properties of compound known as functional groups. What are functional groups? The atom or groups of atom when present in a compound determines the characteristic properties of compound known as functional group. Now here, the several examples of functional groups are given here. Now, the functional group halo. Halo means halogen. Okay, two examples are given from halogen family. One is chloro means chlorine and bromo means bromine. Okay, here, chlorine, if chlorine substitutes hydrogen in hydrocarbon, then it will be termed as chloro. And if bromine substitute hydrogen in hydrocarbon, then it is called as bromo. Okay. Then next one is alcohol. Alcohol functional group denoted by OH. Next, aldehyde functional group denoted by CHO. Ketone functional group denoted by C double bond O. Carboxylic acid functional group denoted by COOH. Example, let's take the example of methane, that is CH4. Now, this is CH4, this is methane, this is also methane. And this is also methane. Now see, if we replace one of the hydrogen from this by any halo group, that is either chlorine or bromine, now this compound is changed from methane. Now it will be either chloromethane or methyl chloride. Means the property of the methane has been changed. Now if we substitute one of the hydrogen by OH, now it becomes alcohol now, that is methanol. Okay. If we substitute this H by this CHO, now this compound is transformed from methane to aldehyde. Understood? Now understand how when these functional groups are present in organic compound, this functional group determines the properties of compound. Understood this? And that's why these are called as functional group. Now look at the definition again. What we have said, atoms or group of atoms. Now here chlorine, it is an atom. Okay, it is an atom. But here OH, it becomes group of atom. Again CHO, it is also a group of atom. Understood this? So here atom or groups of atom when present in a compound determines the properties of that compound known as functional group. Now how the names of this organic compound can be find out, that we will see later in the nomenclature or IUPAC names of organic compound. Understood this? So how many functional group we have studied? One is halo, that is chlorobromo, then alcohol, OH, aldehyde, CHO, ketone, C double bond O, carboxylic acid is COOH. Now, identify this. Now, if I write here, this compound. Now identify whether it is alcohol, aldehyde, ketone, carboxylic acid or alcohol. Now of course it will be alcohol. Why this compound is alcohol? Because OH is here. Understood? And that's why it is alcohol. Understood this? Okay. Now next one is, identify this compound. Now of course, this is carboxylic acid. Because how we recognize this is carboxylic acid functional group? Because we have seen COOH here. Okay, and that's why it is carboxylic acid. So understood? By this way, when this atom or group of atom present in organic compound, this group of atom determines the properties of that compound. Hence they are called as functional groups.